from the Chicago Public Schools have to take remedial classes just to get into the city council.
That's right.
And so I decided you need someone in the office, first of all, that cares about them and that will stand up and make sure that something gets done right about it. And then our people are just going out the world backwards because our neighborhoods have not been developed. We're losing jobs, we're losing homes, we're losing businesses, all of that because we do not have fair and equitable economic development in our neighborhoods. So how can, and this, the TIF money, the tax increment financing money that was supposed to be used to develop white neighborhoods, they are not being used for that purpose. And how can you change that? You have to have someone in that office that will stand up and make sure that it's being used in the right manner. And we can't get contracts. People can't get contracts out of the city. We can't build the capacity of our contractors if they cannot get contracts, or even get subcontracts, or if they get subcontracts, making sure that they are actually being utilized. Because the game that they play is they give you a 30% of the contract, but they forget to call you.
Mm. Yeah.
Huh. Or they forget to pay you. You've done the work, but they forget to pay you. Now you're going to have to go out of business because you can't pay your staff. And who's there to fight for you? No one. So I know these things because I've had experiences with these kind of things over the years. So I want to make a difference. I want to make a change. And then, of course, the crime that's occurring in our neighborhood. It just seems like nobody cares. No one cares. So I'm, and a lot there, and there's a lot of reasons why people permit crime to continue to proliferate in our neighborhoods. Because they want our neighborhoods to be blighted and want us to move out.
That's right.
Right? So it's time, this is a very, very critical election. It matters who goes into the mayor's office this time. It matters. We have to cut off that sprout of devastating our neighborhoods. We have to do it, and we have to do it now. And you have to do it with someone that cares about our neighborhoods. So I have the background, because first of all, I'm an attorney. A lot of people don't know that. I'm an attorney, and the city council is a legal body. It makes laws. And it's important that you have someone that's an attorney to be able to understand that process. That's number one. But then the city of Chicago is in financial straits. And we need someone that understands finances to be able to help stabilize the city's finances. So I'm a certified public accountant, a CPA, and I hold a master's degree in business administration finance. So I have the financial acumen to be able to stabilize the finances as well. So I think I'm qualified. What about you? So I have the background, I have the academic background. But let me tell you about my background in running large municipalities. When I was elected in 2000, I was elected the first African American in the history of Cook County to be the clerk of the court. And it is the second largest court system in the United States of America, maybe even in the world. Second largest consolidated court system. And I have been running that. I have an over $100 million budget. When I started that office, I had about 2,300 employees. Now I have about 1,400 just because of the budget cuts that have occurred because of some other people that's trying to market this office. We won't talk about that. I don't call other people's names. So anyway, and so it's devastated the courts, just horribly devastated the courts. But we're getting the job done anyway. We're getting the job done anyway just because of my ability to make things happen in whatever way we can, change process, business processes, and that sort of thing, to be able to get things done. And so I have been running that second largest court system in the world for over 18 years. And then before I became the clerk of the court, I was head of the art department for the Chicago Transit Authority. Now what I did there was to make sure that those billions of dollars in assets, those buses, those trains, and every part, every rail tie, every tie was properly controlled. All those assets have those that billions of dollars of assets, they have to be properly controlled. When I took over, when I was at CTA, we still had people that were collecting dollars, collecting